Hi, today we will discuss about the electric vehicles. The main discussion is about the range of the electric vehicle and life of the lithium-ion battery it is having. For EVs, we know today's EVs are of not up to the mark as far as range is concerned. The maximum range for two-wheeler that is available on the market today is Okinawa I-Prize, that is with range of up to maximum of 140 kilometer, and as four-wheeler is concerned, it is Tata Nexon EV, the range is up to 300 kilometer. Of course, we are having Kia and Hyundai Kona Electric, but cost is very high. So our discussion is today is about the life of the battery depending upon the range of electric battery. In simple terms, the life of the lithium-ion battery increases with the range of the electric battery. As the range increases, life of the battery also increases. We know for lithium-ion battery, it is having very good shelf life. That means if we keep it ideal, even for 10 years, it will have it full capacity. It won't degrade. So life of the lithium battery is dependent only on the charge and discharge cycles. That means normally lithium-ion battery will retain up to 70% capacity for up to 1500 charge discharge cycles. As far as lithium-ion phosphate battery is concerned, it could be above 2500 or more. There is another battery called lithium-ion and titanium. In that battery, the charge-discharge cycle is approximately 5,000 charge-discharge cycles. So, for the same type of battery, that is, we may take it as lithium-ion battery, it is 1,500 kilometer. So, if the range of the vehicle is more, for the same traveling time, that means if we travel, 50 kilometer, for example, assume that we travel for 50 kilometer. If the range of the battery vehicle, that is two-wheeler, we can take it for two-wheeler. If the range of the battery is, range of the two-wheeler is 100 kilometer, we have to charge it every 2 days. If the range is 250 kilometer. Assume if the range of the two-wheeler is 250 kilometer, we have to charge the battery for the same 50 kilometer, we have to charge it only every 5 days. So what will happen? To reach 1500 charge cycle, the vehicle with lesser range will attain 1500 charge cycle quickly than the range, more range vehicle, that is with for in our example it is 250 kilometer. That means the vehicle with more range has more battery life compared to vehicle with lesser range. That means we have to select a vehicle with capacity. For two wheeler it should be at least 250 kilometer, and for four wheeler it should be at least 500 kilometer. There is another two more advantages for having higher ranges. First one is, as the range increases, ampere hour capacity of the battery also increases for the same voltage. That means capacity of the battery is the product of voltage rating and the ampere hour. For 72 volt battery, if the ampere hour is 100 amp, per hour. Its capacity is 7.2 kilovolt. That means for a battery with higher ampere hour rating, charging current, the rate at which it charges, charging current is more. For that, what does it mean? That means for the 1 minute charge, it can go more kilometer than the battery with lower range, because for lower range battery, ampere hour capacity is less and charging current also less. So with lesser charging current, for 1 minute it can go lesser kilometer. That is one advantage. Another advantage is, as the ampere hour increases, discharging current capacity, the capacity at which the battery can discharge the charging current, that also increases. So as the capacity increases, for lesser charging current, the heat of the battery is very much reduced. So result is, the life of the battery again increases by this. So in any way, as the range increases, life of the battery increases. So we need to select the EVs accordingly. That is, minimum 250 km range for a two-wheeler and minimum 500 km range for a four-wheeler. So now we will see a simple calculation.
Hi. Now we will see the calculation. This is the calculation for vehicles with two different ranges. Now we will see in deep. That means, for assume, if the range is 100 km, we are taking it as for two-wheeler. The battery voltage is 72 volt, ampere hour is 50 ampere hour, so total capacity is 3.6 kilowatt. Load is 1000 watt hub motor. Safe charging current is approximately 5 ampere. Maximum it can go up to 10 ampere with cooling facility. Lesser charging current, that means the charging current capacity is lesser. So more time for 1 kilometer. Then lesser discharge current, which means current capacity, which means more heat, that reduces the life cycle of the battery. Less total lifetime for the same daily use. If per day travel is 50 km for 1500 cycles, it will take approximately 8.3 years for the range of 100 km. Similarly, if we consider vehicle with more range, that means if the range is 250 km, the battery we are taking is 72 volt into 100 Ah is equal to 7.2 kilowatt. Load the same 100 watt. Please don't confuse with the rating of the battery, load and range. This depends upon so many factors. Range depends upon aerodynamics, weight, and so many factors like that. So for the same kilowatt battery and the same load, the range may vary. So don't confuse that. Safe charging current is 10 ampere for this battery, and maximum it can go up to 20 ampere. More charging current means less time for 1 kilometer. More discharge current capacity means less heat, that means more life for the same battery. For if the per day travel is same 50 kilometer. For 1500 cycles, the life of battery is approximately 20 years plus additional life offered by the these parameters. That is, that means lesser heat, that means due to the higher discharge capacity. Thank you.
If you like this video, please share it more, share it for more of your friends, and subscribe for my next video and click the bell icon to get the latest video as I upload.